G'day viewers, welcome back. Andrew Penman here. Dudes, this has got an awesome video today. We got the Verreal all-terrain 6-inch or 150mm pneumatic tires to unbox. So if you get it, it'll sit in a box like this. If you order it individually, it's on page 3 of the accessories page. It's $209 US on the website. The link below, well, actually the code below will give you a $20 discount for that, which will knock it down to 100 and whatever it is, less 20 bucks. You'll get it in a box like this, probably a bit better package because I'm testing it out and unboxing for the first time. So yeah, what you'll get, oh, there's the QA on the top. Love Vic, he listens to riders, listens to what is going on, and we get a lot of feedback on the original all-terrain wheels, and we wanted to have something a little bit special, outside the box thinking stuff, and Vic's done everything that's been required, that the feedback we gave. They're the belts, oh, HD, beautiful, 340 teeth, 15mm, yeah, 5Ms, Kevlar, reinforced, beautiful. You will get the kit with the pulley, as well as, what's this? Oh, yeah, the belt covers, metal. My dentist will hate me for that. Yeah, metal belt covers. As well as the actual pulleys on them. Let's have a look at them. So the kit includes everything. Oh yeah, they're beautiful. They're gorgeous. Oh my God. Yeah, this is a DuPont composite. It's a beautiful, beautiful polymer. It feels like metal. Now Vic's gone for the lightweight, polymer composite plastic on these pulley, opposed to his CNC milling on the cloud wheels on the smaller ones. But for weight and for just for fit, this is beautiful. They're all scalloped out there for the tube fit. Let's see, you can put it anywhere you want. It just fits in this. Let's see how tight they fit. This was a really important factor I fed back. They go in, nice and tight. Even just in half an inch, there's no movement there at all. Oh my God, beautiful. Absolute, the fit is perfection. My God, these look damn sexy. Look really good. 6-inch, my Goldilocks size, I love it. Great for carving. Oh my gosh, the other thing we fed back, the surface area camber on the wheel. My God, can you see that? I think you get the background there. It's literally half an inch resting on the road there. With my weight pushing down, you'll get an inch of contact on the road. That's important because on my tramper, all terrains, unidirectional, I get say 40 PSI. This is gonna be about a 60 PSI tire. I'm gonna try it with 60 PSI, 40, and also 50 PSI and see how it carves. You'll get a good range on this because it's such a sharp curve on that tire. It should carve like crazy. They look beautiful. They are a sexy unit. They stainless steel pins through there with the hex bolts, beautiful. So in the kit you'll get obviously your two rear wheels with the pulleys. You'll get, let's get rid of this box there. You'll get the two front wheels, you'll get the two belts, and you'll get the two motor belt guards. It's an amazing little package. Look, I've never been a really big fan of, all-terrain wheels. I call them pram wheels. But, the more I ride on Sydney Road to the rain we've just had and the storms, it's getting worse and worse. Councils are getting slacker and slacker at fixing roads. I'm now sort of really falling in love with the all-terrain wheel. Why? Because it's very forgiving. It's extremely forgiving. You can go over anything. And also you protect your motors, you protect the whole board because you've got a lot of rebound there. They are just a really nice ride and a really safe ride, and I'm just loving them more and more. My 12 amp hour RS I have had for a year hasn't missed a beat, and I've got the trampers on that. That's a softer ride. This is going to be a much more high dynamic ride, nice carve ride. So I think it's going to be really fun to play with. 50mm by 156 inches. We're going to test them out. We're going to show you a quickly now an installation on, if you're not confident doing it or you're not 100%, I'll show you how to adjust the motor mounts and do this, a few tricks of the trade, get them on the board, and then we'll go for a quick ride. We'll test them out with the three different levels of PSI, as I said. We'll have a look at those, and then we'll see what the best sort of, the best pressure is. And I'm going to then take them out for a ride on a long range distance test. Now, we know that the original the original Cloud's got 50.65, the channel record on my long range. I'm predicting this, the recommended range on this is 41 kilometers. I'm thinking though, you know, if I drop the weight down a bit and, the air down, maybe drop the weight down a bit as well. I think we're gonna get about 50. I'm hoping 50 kilometer range on this, but that's in second gear. That's the recommended speed on this as well, is in speed two. But I won't push it like I did last time on the Clouds and do carving and keep doing the same thing and pressuring it under high speed. So we're gonna do a long range on this that's coming up next week. We'll see what this can do. So if you wanna commute on it commercially, you'll get an idea what it can do. And also we'll take it for a quick ride now. A part of this video will give you my feedback on how they perform. There was a bit of an issue with the actual centering of them before, but now that looks pretty damn good. Yeah, that's pretty impressive. Yeah, so there you go. So there's the all-terrain wheels from Verreal, from Vic, 150mm, 6-inch. It is an incredible addition to your RS. It'll give you another complete aspect of agility and range, but also, you know, it'll give you a lot more options for really rough conditions and those night rides. So, yeah, I can't think enough. 7,000 subscribers, guys. Thank you so much for never tended to set out to do this, just to make videos to help people. And this has been one of the most amazing experiences. And I can't thank you for all the love, all the support. I'll back to my comments again this week. If you have got comments from 3 months ago, I'm going back to those now as well. So I'll get onto those. So yeah, we're gonna get back to everybody. Coming up next week, we got the long range obviously on these RS on my 20 amp hour. We're also going to do an award for the best board of 2020, the overall, you know, overall all-rounder. It's on a black sheet. You won't know what it is until I rip it off and the thumbnail won't give you any clues. That's going to be awarded for the best all-round board for 2020 on my channel. That'll be coming up, as well as the Transite aftermarket optional little extras, little aftermarket add-ons you can do for the Transite carbon hybrid. There's a couple of little things I'm going to show you that you can buy on the website, and Eduardo's got them now in stock. So we'll do that video. And we've got a special mystery board coming up next month, or maybe in the next 4 weeks, which is going to be an amazing pneumatic tire board, carbon fiber, which I think will be, yeah, it'll be a really nice board to test. So guys, thank you so much for joining me. Thank you so much for sitting back tonight and watching that little intro. Let's do the installation. Let's get on the road of a ride. Let's give my feedback on these wheels compared to the benchmark of these, which is the Tramper unidirectionals, are about $700 for the kit with the DuPont, you know, and alloy rims and, you know, anodized and blah, 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 blah. Let's see how they compare. Let's do it. Thanks so much. Love your work. I'll see you in the next video. Till then, happy skating, keep carving, and we'll see you in the next video. Andrew Penman signing off.
Behind me. That's the city of Sydney behind me. Okay, so we're off. Oh, wow, this thing is, look at it. Carves like friggin' crazy. I get around here, the speed bump. Whoa. Yeah, unbelievable. Incredible. Oh yeah, look at that. I'm getting down to about 10 feet. That's just ridiculous. That's just ridiculous. Okay, here we are, late afternoon. You can see the sun's going down. By way of benchmark, I always take my Evolve Limited Edition 1 out for a first ride first. It's got the original, you know, Goldwing copy Evolve trucks. I like to take this for a ride first, then we'll see how the new board performs. Let's get out, have a ride of the new Verreal RS All Train. Is there anyone in there?
No, man.
Any workers or anyone?
No.
Oh, fantastic.
I go there all the time.
Oh, I'm gonna go in there. I heard some noise. I thought, should I better get out of there?
No, you can do the loop.
Oh, awesome.
The only thing, the fences have been burnt out.
Yeah, that's cool. I'll go in there.
They did a bloody safety burn.
Yeah.
Back burn.
Typical.
While it was gusty.
Oh, you're kidding.
But they did it avoiding
the Okay, itself. Sun's going down. I just realised they've blocked this all off. The National Park has blocked off. It says burnt area. Penalties apply for entering closed areas. I'm going to take a risk on this. I'm going to make sure there's no rangers around. I'm going in there. Okay, I always like doing something a bit sketchy and dangerous. I'm in here now. It's a full fine of $300. I'm caught riding in this national park while the bushfire. I get to have it all to myself. There's nobody here. Check it out. All these roads, no one, it's all blocked off. So we'll get the drone up and we'll have a quick ride and I'll let you know, I think. But let's straight away take off my first impressions on the beautiful 5.5 inch little baby all-terrain 60 PSI pneumatic tires for the Verreal RS. And this is the beautiful 20 amp hour. Let's go. Okay, dudes, this will be my first ride. I've only got 3/4 battery, so we're not gonna get a full indication of a full battery punch, but compared to the Evolve just then, let's see what it can do. Let's check it out. Okay. Oh my God. Okay, straight away, this has got far more punch and bite than the Evolve, but it's just this smaller tire, 5.5 inch. It really has this very high camber, so only got like 1/2 inch on the road. It carves like it carves like crazy. Did a turn there so easily. Let's go for a ride, check it out, and I'll get the drone up and we'll have a look. But yeah, so far, absolutely incredible. No loss of torque or power compared to the Clouds. Remember, it's only 29 millimeters bigger than a Cloud wheel, 120, so we're only talking, you know, that much more. But it's not a big wheel, but it really is a nice size. Yeah, loving it. Let's go for a ride. Hey, let's get into it. Let's go. Oh, Jesus. Okay, straight, what's screaming at me straight away is the carve on these wheels, because there's only 1/2 inch, I can just get around a speed bump, there's only 1/2 inch of wheel on the road, so you literally feel like you're riding a racing bike. Jeez, it is unbelievable. It's a speed burst. Yeah, this is beautiful. Oh my God, this is absolutely beautiful. Now these wheels, that 5.9 inch, it's a perfect size. Let's do it. Wow. Let's do a carve now. Let's do a turning circle. And yeah, these wheels are friggin' amazing. So far, no issues at all. I'm loving it. Let's get a view of the board while I'm riding. Check it out. We'll be right back. 5.9 inch wheels. They're not quite 6 inches. They're absolutely beautiful. Dead still, dead smooth. Oh, bit of glass there. incredibly responsive. I can't fault them. The speed, there's no vibrations. They're absolutely beautiful. Speed test now, about 39 Ks now, three quarter battery. Just beautiful. So if you're thinking of getting the all-terrains, I mean, yeah, they're a little bit, they're not cheap, but they're not cheap quality, they're high quality. You'll absolutely love these wheels. I can really carve deep because that camber head. Look at the turn on this, just ridiculous. So yeah, all in all, amazing. I don't give ratings, but this would be a 9.5 out of 10. These wheels are better than my Volt and better than my Tramper. Yeah, better than my Tramper unidirectional 6.5 inch. Unbelievable. Yeah, love them. Vic done a great job. Incredible. You're losing no torque whatsoever. They grip, like, I've just tried to slide them. I can't even slide them unless going sideways. They just are beautiful. And yeah, can't thank you enough, Vic, for letting me review these. They are amazing. And yeah, guys, that will wrap up today. Hope you enjoyed today's installation, Unbox First Ride. We'll see you in the next video with the Tramper comparison, what I'll do with them in terms of speed and braking. Yeah, wow. Got the whole place to myself. It's all shut down. Got the drone up now. We'll see you in the next video. Till then, stay safe, keep carving. Andrew Penman, signing off. Better get out of here. This is a fine I do not want to get. But I had it all to myself, which was freaking amazing. Look at that for a sunset. That's North Sydney. And that's the city. Sorry, Chatswood, North Sydney, and the city. Pretty amazing.